Hello, it's Jang here with a look at the new 2016 LEGO City Fire Station, which comes with everything you see here on screen. This is truly a complete play set with multiple vehicles, plenty of different minifigures to use those vehicles, and then the major building itself, the major fire station, which is kind of split into three parts, two garage buildings and then the one main headquarters. The main building has a really cool new feature in the form of this tall fire pole with a spiral design to it. It's a brand new piece from LEGO specifically for this type of use, and it also has this brand new handle piece, and the pole itself is able to spin around freely. So you see, as I lift this up, the pole is spinning but the handle is just staying in place. But once I get it up here, I'm going to attach it to a figure. He kind of has to take a jump to make it out there. It's not all that close to the building, but you can just snap that right on there, and then when you let go, your person is actually going to spiral around this time. There he goes. The lowermost floor has a rotating main door system where you can put a figure in there and then just spin this around, and that person will end up on the inside. Unfortunately, this first floor only has a single chair as a place to wait, and then a very simple kind of simulated coffee maker there. The second floor is more interesting because it has this dispatch office here with the computer set up. It looks like there's a radar there, and there's also a map, which is a sticker on a panel piece showing you where different incidents are and also where your units are or where they're being dispatched to. The third floor is the rest area, and it just has a bunk bed in it which can accommodate two figures, and there's the window that you would jump out to hop onto the fire pole. The roof doesn't have a whole lot of detail on it, but at least they have a couple of communication dishes up there, and I think it's supposed to represent a little bit of the climate control system and also one antenna. To one side of the main building is one of the garage units, and this is the smaller one with the roll-up door in the front. This one is just large enough to accommodate a small vehicle, so this one fire car is included here. I'll give you a closer look at that. There's also a tool rack over here with some useful firefighting related minifigure accessories, and this smaller garage has on top of it, well, it's got the announcement PA unit over there, and it's the speaker setup, and also a larger satellite transceiver, and you can spin it around and also angle it up and down to make sure it's pointing at the satellite correctly. These garages are very simple in their builds, you know, mostly just these columns here, but I actually like the proportions. I like the thickness of the columns. I just think they look good, and the space underneath there looks kind of believable to me. The other garage is much larger. It is taller and significantly longer, so that one's able to hold a large fire apparatus inside. Once again, just a nice look in here in general. I appreciate just these small little elements that just make this feel like a proper firehouse on the inside. This one on the roof now has the helicopter landing pad, the helipad, and that actually has the little H spot right there, and that will just perfectly fit the helicopter in place. Now, LEGO did a somewhat modular building thing here where they actually have these sections, these angled sections that can be removed and moved around. If you want, you can leave those angled sections out and just use their pins to bring this in all nice and close and have it nice and rectangular, a more slightly more, you know, traditional sort of setup. You can also bring the garages together side to side. It looks like they need to be like this, which also looks pretty good, but it kind of highlights the difference in sizes between the two garage units. You can also turn these around backwards. If you do both of them like that and just connect the buildings back together, it makes a very different shape. So now the whole thing kind of feels like it's a corner unit. You know, it's actually taking up a 45 degree angle here, 90, 90, and just makes the whole thing very compact, but it still is able to hold the vehicle. So you still have the full use of this vehicle bay right here. It's a kind of a good reason that they made that one extra short, and you still have enough space to fit your larger unit in there. So it all ends up working out. This is the new hydraulic aerial unit, which looks pretty impressive. The cab has just some subtle little details to kind of set it apart from other similar overall designs of truck cabs from City. Got the slightly different style for the front with kind of louvers rather than just flat grills. A little bit of a step up here. I actually appreciate that. Of course, you always have your little opening doors on the sides, and you can remove the roof of the cab to get easier access in there. There's nothing extra to see inside. It just has a single steering wheel on one side. That's that. There's a nozzle over here, which is on a hose reel. It's attached to it. The new style of string reel, which has a ball end on it. And that's connecting right now. And that's a little water stud shooter. And you can pull this out. There's plenty of line. Got a little bit of storage there to hold some extra studs, extra water studs, these transparent light blue pieces. This also has stands, which is very important for stability. So you can bring both of those down. With those down, you can check out just what kind of extension you can get out of these booms here. This is actually pretty impressive just how far up this will go. So this one, the base, the lower one, is hooked up with a couple of hydraulic, kind of simulated hydraulic rams, and then the other one doesn't have it, but it's able to go up. And look at this, it's still going up so far. That's quite some reach there. And you just angle your firefighter down, and you have enough hose here to just pull this out carefully. You can reach all the way up there, put this in the hand of your firefighter, and kind of route that around a little bit. And then the entire thing is on a turntable, so you can rotate it around. So this has really good reach, and I think it looks very good when it's extended out. I think it looks a lot better up like this than it did just all packed up for travel. The other side of the truck has two of the little containers that you can use to store minifig equipment in addition to your little water stud pieces. And taking a closer look at the bucket up here, pretty straightforward, mostly just one piece. And you know, it's just a spot for a minifig to sit there, but it works well. It does its job, and it's able to swivel up and down. One thing that's awkward is that it actually can swivel from side to side, so watch out for that. The fire helicopter in this set is a little bit less special, I would say. It's got a very small main rotor and a very large vertical stabilizer. It just feels like the proportions are a little bit awkward on this one. It's supposed to be a tanker, so this is representing a big water tank, or you could imagine it's a foam tank or a foaming agent tank, but it does have just a single nozzle on the end. It's again that exact same little piece that has the ball end on it, so it allows you to turn it in all kinds of different directions. You can just target around, or you can take it off and use it with a minifigure. On the back, they do have storage for studs, so your little water studs can be filled up back there. And you know, a little bit of engine detail and exhaust detail. Of course, always you've got your props, your rotors that can be rotated around. A very squarish, basically one-piece tail boom. It's all one very large rectangular piece. This one's not all that great to me personally. A little floodlight on the side and just a canopy piece that they've been using for quite some time. You know, it does its job, but it's not, like I said, not too special. This little car can be seen as the fire chief's car, his personal transportation for incident command and such, and possibly for first responding, but they don't have any space for a fire extinguisher in there, unfortunately. Just has his extra breathing apparatus set up, just like you saw on the other firefighters. So like this, all that extra stuff is included in the back there. Lego's been doing fire chief cars for a lot of decades, and I think this one is perfectly fine. I think it just fits into the general simplicity and wholesomeness of the original fire chief car theme, and it's done well, I think, for the modern age, the modern styling. I always appreciate these double-sided roof pieces as well. It's just a nice, very useful piece for building things. And this is actually a print on the front that they introduced for this year. So no sticker there, but that's a sticker and that's a sticker. Most of the things that you see in this set that look like decorations actually are stickers. You can open up these doors, but it doesn't give you much access. For the most part, you're just gonna take the roof off to get your figure in and out. Here are the first four of the firefighter minifigs in this set, showing you all of the combinations of torso and leg prints. On the left is the fire chief, and on the right is the helicopter pilot. The others can be or do whatever you like, and of course you can swap things around as you like. None of these have alternate faces, but there are the back prints. Here's one additional firefighter who's also included in this set, and he's set up with his full breathing apparatus and the air tanks and the visor and everything. They give you a total of three of those sets in the set that you can use on any of the characters as you like. And the guy on the right, he's just a hot dog stand attendant, you know, vendor. And why is he here? Where there is a hot dog stand dude, there is a hot dog stand nearby. And here is his stand on fire. So with this set, you get the full fire department, and this is what you get to rescue, what you get to save. Tiny little hot dog stand, which I think looks really cool. It's a little bit on the wide side to put on to a sidewalk or something, but it looks really good. It's got the little bath there, which has a couple of hot dogs in it. And there's also a leg of poultry of some sort that he sells out of the back of this thing as well. It's a nice color. I haven't seen this color used on this umbrella style of piece before. It's got the mustard on one side and ketchup on the other. And the fire element is removable. So if you use one of the little stud shooters with the water pieces, then you can knock that off and supposedly put the fire out. Last but not least, where there is a fire department, there is a fire department dog nearby. Not the ideal combination of print and shape overall, but it gets the idea across, and I think that most kids would appreciate this. In many ways, this can be seen as an evolutionary revamp of the 2013 fire station, the last one from the LEGO City line, but this one has a much, much better fire truck, and just feels like the entire thing has more play value. Also, to me, looks nicer. I appreciate the ability to change things around, you know, just to reorganize the major sections of buildings so you can change the shape of the thing so it can fit into a smaller space if you want to. And this has a lot more parts than the last one and is sold at the same price. So value, I feel, has gone up significantly here. I feel like the aesthetic, you know, the looks of things have improved a fair amount, and the play value has gone up too. A lot of folks regularly question why LEGO keeps making more police and firefighting stuff, and the answer is very simple. Millions of kids worldwide love these types of themes, and they make new versions and new designs of similar types of things, like another fire station here, because they do it better, or at least they try to do it better each time. And I think this time they definitely succeeded. Let me know your thoughts about the set by leaving a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.